So the Indians have deemed Chief Wahoo no longer appropriate for on-the-field use. Max, I'll start with you. How will the removing of the Wahoo logo affect other teams like the Washington Redskins or the Florida State Seminoles, for example?
It will start to have an effect. This is the first domino to fall, maybe, but I have to address what Roger Goodell just said. Shame on Roger Goodell. That is such a, I believe, fundamentally dishonest or at least wrong-headed position to take. Who cares what your fans say if it's the wrong thing to do? There's sometimes right and wrong. And of course he refers to the Washington Post survey, which has been discredited. Probably the best argument, if you really want to get into it, Jacqueline Keeler of The Nation's May 2016 article about how flawed the methodology was that resulted in that poll. And so people who constantly bring up that poll have an agenda. So Goodell has an agenda. He's using that poll because it's easier for him right now to not try to force Dan Snyder's hand. It is an outrage that the Washington team's name is that, period. And it is the right thing to do to change it. And the fact that the Cleveland Indians have started down this path now, I believe will have a domino effect. It is unfortunate that it's taken this long.
Go ahead, Will.
Well, Max, it's just an absurd position to come out and suggest that the Washington Post poll, which, by the way, echoes a 2004 Annenberg poll, is completely rejectionable because it doesn't support your position. The only thing defining right and wrong, if I may, only thing defining right and wrong in your entire position is how you feel, what you think is right and wrong. I think Roger Goodell is incredibly spot on here. What if there is a term that A is not intended to be objective, B is not received as offensive. Not intended to be offensive, not received as offensive, but we've got
it
a third party,
as
represented by you, Max, our great savior
It is received as offensive. That's incorrect.
Just let him speak. Go ahead.
The Washington Post poll, which polled 500 Native Americans, a representative poll of sample size in anybody's methodology.
56% of those people could not identify the tribe with which they were associated.
I truly believe that the compulsion to interrupt me shows a sign of a weakness in the argument, that you don't believe by the end of my statement it will hold up. 9 out of 10 Native Americans have said they do not find the term offensive. It was not just in the Washington Post poll. It was in an 04 Annenberg poll. Similar results. 90% of Native Americans do not find it offensive. Do you also know what is the favorite football team of Native Americans? The Washington Redskins. Do I think there are some that do find it offensive? Yes, I'm sure there are. You can find somebody offended by anything. So I ask you this, how much is enough? Is 10% enough? Need it be 51%? Is it the one man theory, one person finds it offensive? Or is it simply the Max Kellerman theory? When you find it offensive, it should apply to all of us.
If you ignore, apologize for interrupting. I want to make sure I remember all the places you're wrong, and there are a lot of them, so I have to write it down.
All right.
Let me start with the main one. If you ignore problems in methodology, you just accept the finding of the poll. There were lots of problems in the methodology, which is why I referred you to that article, which outlines
from
it very
Nation.
Well. Yes, that's right. I can,
talk
as someone
agenda.
who refers to their own experience, including family members who are Native American in the way they feel. I can tell you from my personal experience, anecdotally, when I go to Native American reservations around the country to call fights, I am approached. I've received feathers in honor and letters saying thank you for your stance publicly. This is the way many of us feel. So the Washington Post, do I believe that's a representative survey of the way Native Americans actually feel about this? No, I do not. But how hard is it for you or anyone to empathize, simply empathize with a group who is defended, even if it is a minority of the group that is offended? And as to the argument, kind of when is enough or when does it end, my friend Brian Kenny, Stephen A., our colleague and good friend from ESPN, now on MLB Network, was tweeting about this last night, and someone asked him about, what about the Fighting Irish? Brian is Irish-American, his father, Charlie Kenny, the late, great Charlie Kenny, bog farmer from Ireland, that's where his people are from, walked the beat in Queens as a cop once he got to this country, was asked about the Fighting Irish and the leprechaun logo. And many Irish-Americans are not offended, but many are. And should that also change?
You answer that.
The answer is yes. Oh my gosh. Unequivocally yes. Pernicious, negative stereotypes of marginalized people that offend even some among them should be changed. It's not that hard.